name is Levina Wanyonyi, procurement manager. And before we continue, I think we can have a word of prayer.
Almighty and everlasting Father, in Jesus' name we come to this morning. We honor and glorify your name, Father. We ask you to have mercy on us for our sins, Father. You have done wrong, Father. Have mercy on us. Thank you for gathering us this morning, Father, for this function, Father. We thank you for giving us the strength, the energy to be here today, Father. We shall not take it for granted, Father. Almighty, as you are gathered for this exercise, Father, we are asking for your guidance. We are asking for your strength, Father, so that we start and finish the right way, Father. Thank you for everything. We wish success to all who are here, Father, the potential contractors, Father. We thank you for them bringing them here safely, Father, for their desire to work with Kenya so that we promote, we make the roads for this nation, Father. Father, even for their prosperity, Father, beyond, Father, we pray for it, Father. Even if what I have not prayed for, Father, you know our needs, Father, I ask you to provide. I pray all this, trusting and believing in Jesus Christ, our Savior.
I feel very privileged to stand in front of you here and to welcome you to this very, very, very important sanitization workshop. The workshop is on procedures and requirements for filling in a competitive tender document. I say that at the onset, I would say you're so lucky, and I invite you because we have observed over the years that when new contractors go in to fill in your tender document, we've observed that I would say most of the contractors, we've noticed that some of you experience difficulties, challenges in putting in systematically what is actually supposed to be put in your tender document. And there can't be a better time than this morning when that the procedures and the requirements will be presented to you by this team from Kenya, so that by the end of the day, you are actually, the framework is set out in your life.
You are being invited to interact as much as possible. This is your forum. It's not a forum. It's not a classroom. It's a workshop. It's a sensitization workshop for you people. We are here because of that. We are here because we won't get things right. So, I invite you once again, as the presentation is being done, it will be that forum, that time for interaction. Please, I invite you to get in, move in, ask questions, so that you gain as much as possible. That and the minimums that I've made, I wish to declare this workshop open. It's a workshop, but bet in it, get as much as you can. Thank you very much.
Can I set aside 30% of the procurement money for the special group as required in the Treasury Circular 1, 2015. So pay attention, want to have many of you participating to increase even competition. Thank you. When we're doing procurements, we are normally guided by the Constitution of Kenya. Basically, you know, the Constitution of Kenya, the Act has borrowed some information from the Constitution of Kenya. We have things to do with corruption, which are not entertained, collusive practices. We also have chapter 6, which talks about leadership and integrity. So the Act has borrowed some information from the Constitution of Kenya, 2010. We are also guided by the Public Procurement and Asset Disposal 2015. The Treasury Circulars, that is why we are here today, because there was a treasury circular that requires us to set aside 30% of our cash to the special group. And other public procurement regulatory authority directives. Objectives of sensitization. to build capacity of contractors so as to maximize economy and efficiency, to facilitate promotion of local contractors, enhancing competition amongst the contractors, to increase participation of potential contractors, to promote integrity, fairness of the authority procurement process, to increase transparency, accountability in the authority's procurement process. And also, we are building public confidence in our procurement process. You know how the procurement process goes on. Instructions to tenderers, qualification of the tenderer, and one tender per tender. We don't want someone to submit a tender that has a counteroffer. You understand? Yeah. The cost of tendering, which now the government has made it affordable for us. The documents that are requirements, the tendering documents that are required, clarification of the tender document just in case we come up with any clarification. We inform you how we are going to go about it. Preparation of the tender document and the language that is used. The document comprising of the tender. The tender rates, which in most of you have to put VAT inclusive. Tender validity, this one is very important because it will vary. You find some documents have 60 days, you find some documents have 120 days, others 90. This is very key, especially if you're going to take part in a tender that is open to all. If a tender is open to all, it means that the tender validity has to be factored in if you're going to put a bid board. Clarification and pre-award meetings. In most of our tenders, we hold pre-tender site visits. The document will clearly indicate to you when the tender site visit will take place, where, when, venue, and in case of any amendments, you'll find them on our website or that of the treasury in the IFMIS tender portal, just in case there's an addendum. The format and the signing of the tenders. Submission of tenders, where are the documents supposed to be submitted, the deadline of the tender submission, what we should do in case there's a late tender. Of course, we don't accept it. The law does not accept us to accept late tenders. What it talks about in case of modifications and substitution and withdrawals of tenders, and what takes place during tender opening and evaluation. Clarification and contracting of the employer. Examination of tender and determination of its responsiveness. This is what happens during evaluation. Notification of qualified tenderers. This information you all find it under the instruction to tenderers. And in your case, there's a tender securing declaration form that you're supposed to fill instead of a bid board. In case we have any clarifications, amendments that have taken place under the instructions to tender, you find them under the appendix to instructions to tender. For instance, if in the appendix to form of tender, it is indicated a tender security, of course it will be indicated they are not applicable. Like in this case, amount of performance security, it is indicated not applicable because it's not applicable for you. But indeed, we had mentioned it under the instructions to tenderers. But when we come to the appendix supersedes over the instructions to tenderers. Special specifications, technical specifications, section 10, standard specifications. Like in my case, the documents that I have, in the technical specs are that it might require stone pitching, gabion works, backfilling of structures, repair of drains, cleaning and maintenance, passage of traffic, natural gravel, surface and base, bituminous surface treatments, bituminous mixes, bidder courses, and wearing of courses. In this section, basically, what the user does is that they tell you in detail what they expect of a bidder. If you are to bid in that road, What are we Kenya looking at? So they tell you in detail the scope of works. The next section is section 6, which are the drawings. If we have a bridge, definitely we'll have a drawing. If there's a bridge being constructed, we'll have a drawing. Then in our tenders, we also have bill of quantities. Then the standard forms. In any tender that we give you, it always has standard forms. For instance, we have confidential business questionnaire. That is one of our forms, and of which you've asked you to come in each today if you want to be registered. We also have the tender form. We have the declaration form, depending on the document. But what we've done is trying to capture the information of the declaration form in the confidential business questionnaire. Okay, now this, I've noted most of the people failed here. Like in this tender that I'm holding, it is indicated, are you an agent of Kenya National? Okay, it's supposed to be Kenya National Highways Authority. Most people did yes. You failed because your staff of, you have interest. That's basically what you're trying to tell us. You're supposed to dig no. You're not an agent. You don't have conflict of interest. The first statement is to certify that your name, being authorized representative of the company name, you've attended the tender sites for example, I'm holding a tender document for routine maintenance of Magana underpass on A104 road. The qualification is very clear. We are basically supposed to register you, and that's why we are registering you today. Regarding the billboard requirement, you're not supposed to have a billboard. But that does not mean if you're taking part in a tender for all, you don't have a billboard. You're supposed to have, if you feel like you want to do the tenders for all. If you're tendering in any tender for youth, women, and disabled, the circular has also indicated how the tenders are supposed to be separated. Youth are supposed to compete amongst themselves, women are supposed to compete amongst themselves, and the youth amongst themselves and the disabled. Then, now, in the invitation to tender, we normally have a tender notice placed in the newspaper, as well as the IFLIS tender portal, and the Kenya website. On the tender notice, you realize that they have given you some mandatory requirements, some technical requirements. It's important you pay attention to what is written there. Instructions to tenderers, conditions are supposed to rate the bidders on how to fill the tender document properly, and you're requested to read them and that you understand them. If you don't read the conditions, definitely you must fill a tender that is compliant. You're going to leave out some things. If you're being told of the tender validity, you indicate your own validity if you've not read the instructions to tenderers properly. Contractors are supposed to note the date, time, and venue of the pretender site visit. So, also the contractors should note of the date, time, the date of closing, opening of the tenders, and even the venue. That's why I told you, if a tender is for Nairobi region and you take it to headquarter, you're disqualified. You've disqualified yourself, not me. I'm not disqualified you, but you've disqualified yourself. You should also take note of the tender validity period. Some are normally 60, others 90, others 120. So it is very important for you to note that. Different tenders vary depending on the tender. So you're supposed to read, and this is contained under the instructions to tenderers. I'll talk about the tender security, but in your case you're supposed to talk about the tender security declaration form which will come next. Just in case you may be interested in bidding for a tender for all. The tender security validity period is not, might be like 30 days beyond the tender validity period. For example, if the tender validity period is 120 days, then the tender security validity period is 150 days. And 120 to 30. For you to get 150 days. Most bidders fail on the tender security validity period. Because sometimes you'll find that maybe is they factor only maybe the 30 days, they don't print the whole sentence indicating that beyond the tender validity period, which in this case may be 60 or 90 or 120. Okay, the tender security requirements are for those who are dealing with open tender, but in your case you're supposed to give a tender security declaration form for the youth, women, and persons with disability. It should be duly filled and signed. And you know the procurement process has deadlines, so it's good for you to give us contacts that are working. The bill of quantities should be duly filled, and the grant total summary, like I showed you, carried to the tender form. Ensure that you arrange your appendices to the tender documents in a sequential manner using the separators. I would like to urge you, if you are a serious bidder, please use separators. So make your document neat, such that you make even the work for the evaluator faster, and we cannot, your document, let your documents not be a puzzle. Your documents are supposed to be serious. The current Act for 2015 requires that.